Hello and welcome to VLearn. Session 1, Cross-Culture and Global Resource Management, Introduction to International HRM. Topic will be cover, Introduction, International HRM, Objectives of International HRM, Issues in International HRM, Barriers to Effective Global HRM, Difference between Domestic HRM and International HRM, Factor that influence the global work environment. Now, yes, as you are going to study about the cross-culture environment, what exactly the cross-culture environment? So we need to study about the international dimensions of in a business. It is one of the thing of understanding the international concept and international dimensions of the businesses and the globalization of a business. As we all know that globalization is one of the factor which puts the effect on the business and which actually lead the organization towards one of the goal oriented or make the organization more profitable, more goodwill concept, more towards the growth part. So in that case, yes, and if we were taking consider all that, so that means organizations try to expand their business, organization try to improve their business. Just for the expansion, they need to enter into the new market, they need to enter into the new countries, new boundaries. So in that terms, just for entering the new countries and new boundaries, it needs to understand the cultural concept, which is one of the part in the HRM to study. That means what is exactly the cultural concept in it. So international dimension of a business and the globalization of a business is having a significant impact on the human resource management. Yes, as we say that the for the growth purpose organization move towards the new boundaries. So in that terms, it always affects or it always put an impact on the human resource management. It is therefore essential that a study on the concept of international management is necessary to understand the concept of international HRM. Yes, it is very much important to understand what is international management before going to understanding about the HRM, international HRM. If I talk about the international management is all about the focus of the international business is on the international transactions. Whereas international, we can say that international management is what the managing such transactions with the boundaries set by the cooperative strategy. That means if the companies was looking towards managing their activities, managing their performances, managing their corporate strategies, these all comes into the international management. Kis tarike se business perform kar sakti hai, kis tarike se business increase ho sakta hai, क्या स्ट्रैटेजीज एक बिजनेस अडॉप्ट करेगा, व्हाट वाज द एग्जैक्ट मार्केट, उस कंट्री की एग्जैक्ट एनवायरनमेंट क्या है, ये सब की स्टडी, इन सब के अंडरस्टैंडिंग स्ट्रैटेजी फॉर्मुलेट करके ग्रोथ को ऑपरेट करना, वो सब इंटरनेशनल मैनेजमेंट के अंदर आता है. सो इन दैट टर्म्स, यस, द फील्ड ऑफ इंटरनेशनल एचआरएम, इंटरनेशनल एचआरएम, जैसा कि इंटरनेशनल मैनेजमेंट की बात हो रही है, कि इट इज ऑल अबाउट जनरेटिंग द एक्टिविटीज और टेकिंग द कंसिडरेशन ऑफ द एक्टिविटीज. At the same time, international HRM is of the same concept. That means it is was taking care of the human respect of the countries, and that means considering the human factors of the countries. So yes, the field of international HRM is characterized by three appraisals. So in that terms, तीन अप्रेजर्स इसके अंदर इंक्लूड होते हैं अगर हम इंटरनेशनल मैनेजमेंट की बात करते हैं, ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट की बात करते हैं. फर्स्ट इज क्रॉस कल्चर मैनेजमेंट, अनदर इज कंपेटिटिव इन इंडस्ट्रियल रिलेशंस, अनदर इज एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ एचआरएम इन द मल्टीनेशनल फर्म्स. इन दैट टर्म्स, यस, इफ यू नो दैट देयर इज एन ओवरलैप बिटवीन दैट थ्री अप्रोचेस, व्हेन one is attempting to provide an accurate view of global reality of operating in the international business environment. So obviously the cross-culture management issues are basically important when the deal, because when we were entering into the any kind of in a country, that means we were dealing with the cultural aspect of that foreign country. So in that case, the we would have to deal in the different kind of operations. So that's very obvious. That's one of the cross-culture management is the important aspect to be understand. International HRM, we can state it as IHRM. Isko IHRM bhi bol sakte hain. That means it can be defined as a set of the activity aimed managing organization human resource at international level to achieve the organizational objective and achieve the comparative advantage over the competitor at nation level एंड इंटरनेशनल लेवल. इन दैट टर्म्स देखिए वो एक्टिविटीज़ होती हैं जिसके थ्रू जितने भी हमारे ऑर्गेनाइज ह्यूमन रिसोर्स होते हैं दे ट्राई टू पुट द बेस्ट जस्ट टू अचीव दैट ऑब्जेक्टिव्स एंड जस्ट टू अचीव दैट कंपैरेटिव एडवांटेज इन द नेशनल एंड इंटरनेशनल लेवल. सो इन दैट टर्म्स येस HRM concept is very much same, but yes, the bigger dimension is the international human resource management. जो अगर हम HR की बात करते हैं तो HR is dealing with people, motivating them just to fulfill the organization objectives and all. So international HRM is more or less the same, but with very broader scenarios, but with the very broader concepts. So we can say that this International HRM can be defined as an HRM concept and technique employees used to manage the human resource challenges of their international operations. So it focuses on the three concepts. One is of managing the HR in the global companies, whatever the global companies is, aap unke saath manage kar rahe ho, ye ek concept uske andar add on hota hai. Second is managing the expatriates employees, that means जितने भी expatriates employees होते हैं उनके साथ deal करना. Then comparing the HR practice in the variety of different countries, that means कि आपकी अलग अलग countries के अंदर किस तरीके की HR practices हैं. So that leads towards the HR, international HRM part. So yes, international HRM include typical HRM functions such as recruitment, selections, training, development, performance appraisals and dimensional done at the international level, and additional activities such as global skills management, expatriates management and so on. So yes, the concept like recruitment, agar main recruitment, selections, training, development, performance appraisals ya dismissals ki baat karu, to wo sare concept international level par bhi use hote hain. So international level par use hone ke sath sath this is another concept jo ki isme add hote hain, that is global skills management and expatriates management. So in that case, yes, this is again the reason why we said that international HRM is the broader one concept. In simple terms, we can say that international human resource management is concerned about managing human resource at multinational company, and it involves the managing the three type of employees. Now we discuss about ki kis kis tarike ke IHRMs hote hain, teen tarike se, ya to aap kisi global company mein HR ko manage kare aur aap expatriates employees ko manage kare, ya unki ki hui practices ko dusri countries ki HR practices ke sath compare kare. बट येस, एक मल्टीनेशनल कंपनी में या एक ग्लोबल कंपनी के अंदर भी किस किस तरीके के एम्प्लॉयज़ हो सकते हैं. अब इन अ ब्रॉडर सिनेरियो, येस, डिफरेंट डिफरेंट कंट्रीज से डिफरेंट डिफरेंट लोग आके ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में परफॉर्म करते हैं, अपनी स्किल्स पुट डाउन करते हैं ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के अंदर. सो इन दैट टर्म्स तीन तरीके के एम्प्लॉयज़ इंक्लूड होते हैं. फर्स्ट इज होम कंट्री एम्प्लॉयज़. होम कंट्री एम्प्लॉयज़ बेसिकली वो होते हैं एम्प्लॉयज़ बिलोंगिंग टू द होम कंट्री ऑफ अ फर्म वेयर द कॉर्पोरेट हेड क्वार्टर्स. इन दैट टर्म्स येस, जहाँ पर हमारे कॉर्पोरेट हेड क्वार्टर बना होता है उसी कंट्री से बिलोंग करते हुए अगर एम्प्लॉयज होते हैं सो वो होम कंट्री एम्प्लॉयज होते हैं. सेकेंड, होस्ट कंट्री एम्प्लॉयज. होस्ट कंट्री एम्प्लॉयज आर बेसिकली एम्प्लॉयज बिलोंग्स टू द नेशन इन विच द सब्सिडरी इज सिचुएटेड, यानी कि जिस सब्सिडरी कंट्री के अंदर आप जाके बिजनेस कर रहे हो वहाँ के अगर आप एम्प्लॉयज लेते हो तो दे कम्स एट अ होस्ट कंट्री एम्प्लॉयज. थर्ड कंट्री एम्प्लॉयज आर, दीज आर एम्प्लॉयज हु आर नॉट फॉर दी होम कंट्री और होस्ट कंट्री बट आर एम्प्लॉयड एट अ सब्सिडी और अ कॉर्पोरेट हेड क्वार्टर. वी कैन टेक दैट कि इफ आई एम इन अ कंपनी एक्स वाई जेड कंपनी और मैं इंडिया में परफॉर्म कर रही हूँ बट आई एम नॉट टेकिंग माई ओन कंट्रीज पीपल और आई एम नॉट टेकिंग द इंडियन कंट्रीज पीपल इन माई ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, आई एम टेकिंग द अनदर्स कंट्री पीपल इन माई ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, दैट्स कम्स इन टू द थर्ड कंट्रीज एम्प्लॉयज. So in that case, we were taking the example also like American MNCs, which has a subsidy at India, may employ a French people as a CEO to subsidize. So in that case, the Frenchman employed is a third country employee. So in that term, that person is not American, that's not Indian, but it's a French person related to the another country. So that comes into the third country employee. Now, what are the various objectives of international HRM? International HRM ke kya kya objectives hain? If we study about the objective, The first objective is to reduce the risk of the international human resource. Yes, just to managing, if the organization or any kind of company enter into the country, so in that terms, that company has to deal with the aspects, the environments, the different concept of that country, the either it's a political, it's technical, the even the cultural part or the social part or any kind of a geographical part. So company has to deal with all of that. So in that case, yes, it is very much essential to reduce the risk of the international human resource. That means aap jo bhi human resource generate karte ho jis country mein bhi jaake, aap unke risk ko minimize karo. Just to avoid the cultural risk. At the same time, yes, एक ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के अंदर डिफरेंट कंट्री से या डिफरेंट कल्चर के लोग परफॉर्म करते हैं. इन दैट टर्म्स आप किसी भी तरीके के कल्चरल रिस्क, यानी कि एक कल्चर हर्ट होने की वजह से, एक कल्चर प्रॉपरली फॉलो ना होने की वजह से जो भी रिस्क अराइज होता है, उसे अवॉइड करने के लिए भी हमें HRM की ज़रूरत होती है. देन टू अवॉइड द रीजनल डिसपार्टीज, दैट मीन्स जब किसी भी तरीके के रीजनल कॉन्सेप्ट होते हैं तो उनको लेकर किसी भी तरीके की प्रॉब्लम्स या किसी भी तरीके की कन्फ्यूजन्स ना क्रिएट हो, उसे अवॉइड करने के लिए भी वी नीड इंटरनेशनल HRM. देन टू मैनेज द डाइवर्सिफाइड ह्यूमन कैपिटल. यस, डाइवर्सिफाइड ह्यूमन कैपिटल इन टर्म्स ऑफ दैट्स द सेम कि एक कंपनी के अंदर बहुत सारे ऑर्गेनाइज अलग अलग कल्चर के बहुत सारे अलग कंट्री से बिलोंग करते हुए लोग काम करते हैं. सो इन दैट टर्म्स किसी भी तरीके की डाइवर्सिफाइज या टू किसी भी तरीके की जो वेराइटीज़ हैं अलग अलग, वो आपस में क्लैश ना करें, डिडंट फाइट विद ईच अदर, और वो अच्छे से ऑर्गेनाइजेशन की पॉलिसीज के हिसाब से परफॉर्म करें. दैट्स इज द अनदर ऑब्जेक्टिव, टू मैनेज द डाइवर्सिफाइज ह्यूमन कैपिटल. जो भी मेरे पास अलग अलग कल्चर से रिलेटेड जो एम्प्लॉयज़ हैं, वो किसी भी तरीके से कन्फ्यूजन्स या किसी भी तरीके की प्रॉब्लम्स ना क्रिएट हो, उसे मैनेज करने के लिए. Another is issue in international HRM. किस तरीके के issues arise हो सकते हैं in international human resource management. First is managing the international, that means managing the international IRM. In that terms, yes, we can say that this continue to be the most popular kind of a technique. The article about the selection, training, compensation, of the expatriate employees have failed. So many articles refer to the expatriate management as a major concern of the HRM managers in the multinational corporations. In that terms, yes, आपके जितने भी expatriate employees होते हैं, उन्हें किसी तरीके की problems arise ना हो, उन्हें किसी तरीके की issues ना arise हो, उसे minimize करने के लिए भी एक ये बड़ा issue होता है जो कि एक HRM को consider करना होता है. Then employees and families adjustment. Yes, people basically adjust to the expedited assignments can be extremely challenging regardless of the countries. In that terms, yes, बहुत सारी families move on होती हैं, बहुत सारी जो expatriate families होती हैं वो भी owner party के साथ country by country move होते हैं. In that terms, उनकी adjustment भी एक बहुत बड़ा concept होता है. Then selecting the right person for a foreign assignment, that means this is a critical for the success, because expatriates must be personal adaptability and their family capable of adjusting to new and unusual challenges. So orientation and training are required in that case, that means valuable in the helping those people and families just to adjust in the new climate and learn a new language. So the compensations plans is one of the solution can be arise in it. So in that terms, yes, selecting the right person for the foreign assignment, कि आप किसी भी foreign assignment के लिए जिस person को भेजो, वो और उसकी families उस environment में, उस foreign countries में जाके adjust कर सके, that comes into the selecting the right person for the foreign assignment. Then cultural communication and gauge, that means international HR professionals are basically expected to understand the implications of cultural difference between. So countries and their interplay with the defining the corporate culture. So they often are responsible for seeing that the expatriates are trained to adapt the culture differences and overcome the culture stops. So also the HR professionals play an important role in cultural mingling. In that terms, yes, किसी भी तरीके की प्रॉपर कल्चर्स, प्रॉपर कम्युनिकेशन, प्रॉपर गियर्स को मेंटेन करने के लिए इट इज़ रिक्वायर्ड टू हैव अ कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन फ्रॉम द HR कॉन्सेप्ट की जब आप उनकी हेल्प करते हो, उनकी इंट्रोडक्शंस उनके साथ कोऑर्डिनेट करवाते हो ताकि वो उस नए कल्चर के अंदर इन्वाइट एडजस्ट कर सके और कोप अप कर सके. देन लैंग्वेजेस एंड कम्युनिकेशन, येस इट इज़ वन ऑफ द अनदर कॉन्सेप्ट in inviting the human resource into the different countries. So in that case it must learn the foreign language or maybe interrupt the communication with the local workforce. So in that case present companies officials may be struggle to communicate with the local managers in the foreign subsidies. So because of the human resource professionals are often expected to foster the international communication, so they must understand the effective communication involves more than just speaking the same language. So to communicate effectively, individuals must share to deeper meaning that are often the try to culture norms and tradition. In that terms, yes, बहुत ज़्यादा ज़रूरी नहीं होता कि हर बार एक same language के साथ communication किया जाए. This probably can be happen on the understanding basis कि एक किस तरीके के जो meaning जो इंटरप्रिटेट कर रहा है सेंडर, वही जो मीनिंग है उस तरीके से ही रिसीवर भी उसे ले रहा है. सो इन दैट केस येस देर आर लैंग्वेजेस एंड कम्युनिकेशन इज अगेन वन ऑफ द इशू इन द इंटरनेशनल HRM. देन बैरियर्स टू इफेक्टिव ग्लोबल HRM, येस व्हाट आर द वेरियस बैरियर्स जो कि एक इफेक्टिव ग्लोबल HRM क्रिएट नहीं करने देते. बैरियर्स में सबसे पहले है देर आर नंबर ऑफ यूनिक प्रॉब्लम्स दैट ग्लोबल कंपनी फेसिंग. So in that terms, what are the first problem? That is variation. Variation is one of the biggest challenge amongst that cross-cultural concept, because the worldwide variation in social, political, economical circumstances was always there. In an HR practice that work in one country may be unacceptable in the another. So the fluctuating in currency, government regulation, compensation expectations, job securities, learning styles are just a few examples of the local variations of the global HR professional faces. So in that terms, yes, it is required to understand those kind of in a circumstances and taken steps according to that circumstances. But yes, variation in the social, political, economical scenarios or cultural scenarios is one of the barrier for the effective global HRM. Then perception of HR, that means the another challenge in it. In that case, in one country, suppose HR may be perceived as a true business partner working with a high level managers on the critical strategic assessment in the other country, but within the same company, HR may be viewed as a transaction personal department that handle the administrative work. So this is the with one of the example of the two concepts कि जहाँ पर एक वो country है जहाँ पर HR जैसे concepts को और HRs को बहुत values दी जाती हैं, whereas ऐसी भी companies हैं जहाँ पर HRs को इतनी values नहीं दी जाती और उनको सिर्फ एक transactional personal की तरह लिया जाता है. In that terms, दो अलग countries, दो अलग concept, दो अलग thinking. So perception is again one of the concept to be considered or as in a barrier. Then attitude and the actions of headquarters towards HR. That means this help to determine how seriously the HR function is viewed locally. In that terms, the position of a corporate chief HR officer also sends signal to the local unit on the importance of HR function. In that terms, yes, getting out the idea about that how important the HR is, HR kitna important hai, just to consider that. Then resistance to change. In that case, yeah, a third party major challenge facing the global HR practices is that different locations have their own way of doing things and resisting basically the change. If an HR initiate that is viewed as in a corporate is imposing on the local HR staff, then it can be difficult to gain the acceptance from the field. So that's basically a true regardless of a whether it is USA multinational forcing initiatives on its local business or it's the general company or the German company forcing the policy and practices on the international business. That means kis tarike ki international business practices ek organization ki hai, jis tarike ki ek organization ki practices hoti hai, usi tarike ki organization's performance bhi hoti hai. Then cultural difference in learning and teaching style, yes, The learning concept, suppose the education sector is very much different from the others' education area. So in that terms, yes, the different learning was they learn, different training was they have. So in that terms, yes, when the future of the country perform in the organization, definitely they carry those cultures, learnings, teacher with them. So in that terms, yes, it is what the one of barrier, that is cultural difference in the learning and teaching style. Now, what are the difference between the domestic HRM and international HRM? If we talk about the difference between, the first difference is domestic HRM is done at the national level and international HRM is done at the international level. So in that case, yes, हमारा जो HRM है वो बहुत ज़्यादा national तरीके से perform होता है, nationally सारी activities होती हैं, जबकि international HRM की international basis पर. Then domestic HRM is concerned with managing the employees belonging to one nation, and HRM is concerned with. That means it is what domestic HRM is basically concerned with, that that how to manage the one nation, what was the IRM. So in that case, with managing the employees belonging to many nations, in that case considering the employees जो कि बहुत अलग अलग origin से या country से आए होते हैं, nation से आए होते हैं. Third difference is domestic HRM is concerned with managing the limited number of HRM activity at the national level, and international HRM has a concern with managing the additional activity such as PTES management. In that terms, yes, जहाँ पर एक HRM concept जो हो रहे हैं वो इतना ज़्यादा manage नहीं कर पाता कि profit low है तो क्यों है, workers low retentions हैं तो क्यों low retentions हैं. So in that terms, yes, IHRM having the concern with, या जबकि जो international human resource management होता है वो एक additional practices, additional activity add on करता है domestic HRM के अंदर. Then domestic HRM is less complicated due to the less influence from the external environment, whereas the international HRM is very complicated as it is affected heavily by the external environment. So in that terms, yes, it is required to understand the culture of the international HRM through any kind of research. So whereas domestic ke andar itni researches karne ki zarurat nahi padti, but international human resource management ke andar company required to have a certain kind of understanding or influencing behavior. Then factor that influence the global work environment, kaun kaun se aise factors hain jo global work environment ko affect karte hain. Sabse pehle the require of any to have, that means the multinational enterprises, it should be flexible enough, it should be local responsiveness was there, knowledge will be there, and competitive transfers will require to be there. So in that terms, yeah. So required M&E to have, it should be required to have them flexibility, local responsiveness should be there, knowledge sharing was proper, knowledge sharing was there, and yes, the competencies transfer required to have them. So required M&E to have all these factors, and that further leads to the managerial responses. All these managerial responses convert them developing the global mindset, informal control mechanism was there, horizontal communication required to have, cross border and the vital teams was required there, then international assignments was required. But due to this process, after that defining the survival and growth, there was one factor who affect them. That factor is force for the change. That means it is related to the certain kind of a force, certain kind of a factor, this leads to the certain kind of a changes जो आपको change करने पे मजबूर या किसी भी तरीके की factor influencing में बहुत ज़्यादा effect करता है. In that terms, the force of the changes for cover any kind of a global competition, any kind of mergers, acquisitions, any kind of any organization restructuring or advance in the technologies and telecommunications. So these are the basically force for the change. Then yes, there are a few questions which you have to do it yourself. First is, what is international HRM? Explain its objective and importance. You have to explain that IHRM kya hota hai, it is international concept, or kis tarike se kaam karta hai, uske objective and important. And yes, what are the various factors which are influenced by the global work environment? Jo bhi global work environment hai, usme kaun kaun se aise factors hain jo affect karte hain. So you have to explain that whole diagram jo ki abhi discuss kiya tha. So yes, we were winding up here. This is all about for the today's session. So thank you so much. Happy learning. We learn.